Hello and welcome to Pacific Dialogue. I'm your host, Fang Fang. Ever wonder who's winning the battle of the unicorns? Is it China or the US?
Hello, I'm Li Qing. We're here in Beijing Central Business District. Today, we're going to talk to people about the unicorn companies.
听过，但具体是什么我不太清楚。
Billion dollar unlisted company.
应该还是美国吧。
China.
Either the United States or China.
Oh, it's Singapore.
Maybe China, I don't know. Because we're in China and you're asking me in China. I feel like it might be China.
Maybe India.
Xiaomi. Xiaomi.
No.
Airbnb.
坐滴滴。
这个滴滴打车。
AXA, maybe? Is that possible? No, it's not.
不认识。
Oh, SpaceX, yeah. Okay.
Uber, 优步。
This one's Uber, yes.
美团。
美团外卖, 美团的。
In 2017, a report stated that there were 252 unicorns worldwide. Really small club, right? China had 98, while the US topped the list with 106. As of early July, 46 more startups joined the unicorn team, according to CB Insights. China had 16 new unicorns, and the US had 17. People keep asking, how in the world did China become the US leading rival? First of all, both countries have a huge market which provides rich soil for startups. And after all, they are the world's largest economies. But they also have many differences. On this point, we talk with Associate Professor Gao Yuning from Tsinghua University.
From the US side, the unicorn companies are dominated by the business service. China's unicorns are maybe more would like to serve the consumer themselves.
It's also not fair to compare advancement only in terms of cutting-edge technologies, industries, or consumers. The two countries have totally different historical and cultural backgrounds. But what's the fundamental difference between Chinese and US entrepreneurs? We asked Yu Guangdong, an experienced unicorn hunter, for his views.
其实创业对于中国来说，其实是近20年的事情，所以我们其实在很多创业的过程当中，更多的还是用类比法的创业。美国的创业者，其实我也接触过一些，其实他们的独角兽的创业者，更多的在于一些，比如说革命性的，或者说技术创新型的这样的一些东西。It's
no secret that the U.S. is an innovative trailblazer, while China offers the largest group of young engineers in the world. Maybe cooperation is a good idea. The two could learn a lot from each other, right? We spoke with some experts about how China and the US could work together.
中国的很多独角兽创业更多的是在如何提高效率，如何降低成本。
I think the US side that, for example, when they want to, you know, make their business growing even larger, I think they should also serve the people of the world, not just elites of the US.
Many companies with their design sectors in California have their value chain and production base in China. This is actually a very typical model in the globalized world. But will trade tensions between the US and China do harm to this model? It remains to be seen. But for now, it's safe to say the unicorn battle will continue. But just maybe, it can develop in a cooperative way. Thanks for watching. See you next time.